U ovoj pesmi dame će pevati sa mnom, pevaćemo jedan kanon, a muškarci će pevati sa Jovanom i sa Aleksom. Samo nas pratite i vrlo brzo ćemo da naučimo.
Da čistim grehe srca moga. Imam veliku čast i privilegiju da vas pozdravim ovog večera i da vas puno, puno zahvalim što ste stigli na vreme na proučavanje koje imamo večeras i na naš sabor sa kojim smo se sakupili. Imamo veliku privilegiju da u našoj okolini večeras imamo gosta iz Australije, Dušan Milosavljević sa nekim members of his family, sa familijom isto tu. Nešto više o njemu i njegovoj istoriji čućemo sutra pre podne kada bude glavno predavanje. Tema celog sabora jeste Isus je rešenje za nas, je li tako? Isus je ključ. Ali, šta bih hteo ovog puta da malo razmišljamo? A to jeste, zašto se mi sakupimo na ove sabore? Da se družimo. Da se ne zaboravimo. Da se susretnemo jedan sa drugim. Po našem običaju, ovo je sada 52. sabor, koliko se ja sećam. I na ovom saboru, ako se ne varam, ima osoba koje su bili na svih 52 sabora. Vidim brata Selaka i sestru Melu Selak. Ja verujem da su oni bili na svih ovih saborima. Ja sam na saboru već 42 godine. Znači da se ja ubrajam u broj koji smo malo već ostarili. Sakupljamo se da bi se sastali, da bi održali prijateljstva koje smo sastavili. Isto imamo oni koji su možda i po prvi put danas ovde. E, ja mogu reći sigurno, evo, moja unuka je prvi put ovde na saboru danas. I za nju je ovo prvi put da se sastane sa nekim između nas. Ali ovog sabora ne samo da se sastanemo jedan sa drugim, da obnovimo prijateljstva jedan sa drugim. Treba se podsjetimo glavni razlog zašto da dođemo tu. Jeste da se susretnemo sa živim Isusom. Ovo je tema našeg sabora ovog vikenda. Da se susretnemo sa živim Isusom. Ja nisam mnogo o tome razmišljao pre ovog puta kad sam dobio ovu priliku da vas pozdravim na sabor. Za mene je većinom sabor bio velika obaveza. Juri ovamo, juri onamo, daj da se ovo sredi, daj da se ovo organizuje. Nisam mnogo puta mislio da dođem da se sastanem sa živim Isusom. Ali ovog puta želio bih da malo se usporimo naš život, da stvarno uzmemo malo vremena da se sastanemo sa živim Isusom. Ovog večera i ovog vikenda ne samo da imamo privilegiju da se sastajemo sa nama koji smo ovdje u sali, jedan sa drugim fizički, nego imamo privilegiju da budemo zajedno sa ljudima oko celog sveta. Naša tehnika je ovdje ustavljena, tako da predavanje ovog celog sabora nosi se preko interneta i svako ko ima vezu može se priključiti. Znači, oni koji su u Australiji, ima neko koji je u Africi, neko iz Srednjeg istoka, iz Evrope, iz naše stare domovine. Svako ima priliku da se priključi nama, a isto i njih pozivam da bi uzeli malo vremena da se susretnu sa živim Hristom. Za nekog ovaj vikend može da bude prvi put da je dobio ovaj poziv da se upozna sa živim Hristom. Nemamo izgubiti ovu privilegiju da se usporimo i da stvarno imamo priliku da se upoznamo sa živim Hristom, kroz koje će nas proučavanje voditi Dušan Milosavljević. I would just like to welcome you in English as well, those of you who may not understand our beautiful native language. Those of you who are joining us via the internet around the world, we welcome you. And we invite you to be part of our celebration. And a celebration this weekend is focused around meeting the live Jesus. In other words, meeting the real Jesus. Not just meeting one another as friends, which is very, very important and gives us a reason to move forward. But we want to step back a little bit and not just focus on our internal friendships, but let's focus on the friendship and meeting the real live Jesus this weekend. Our pastor and our guest speaker from Australia, who is joining us here with his family, will be leading us in this discussion and thought process throughout the whole weekend. Our guest is Dušan Milosavljević, whom we will hear from, this evening and tomorrow morning and in the afternoon. And you will hear a little bit more of his history and his background tomorrow when we have our service. I don't want to prolong this introduction because we certainly want to move on with the program. So we welcome you and feel refreshed, feel rested. We'll have some announcements towards the end of the program about organizational aspect of it, when the breakfast is and lunch and all that stuff tomorrow. But for now, enjoy the evening. We welcome you and we wish you God's blessings.
Pognimo glavu na molitvu. Dobri naš nebeski Oče, iz svega srca smo ti zahvalni na tvojoj velikoj milosti i ljubavi koju si iskazao prema nama. Doveo si nas na ovo mjesto, čuvao si nas svojim anđelima. Gospode, mi smo ispunjeni radošću i zahvalnošću. Hvala ti na tvojoj riječi koju si spreman da nam daš i ovoga večera. Gospode, mi znamo tvoju riječ, mi smo ju proučavali lično, čuli smo tvoja djela iz prošlosti, šta si sve učinio za svoj narod. Gospode, mi ne želimo biti samo oni koji nose znanje o tome, već želimo iskusiti tu tvoju riječ u svome životu. I zato te molimo da moćno djeluješ ovoga dana na nas, lično, na naše obitelji, na našu djecu, da nakon ovoga sabora budemo promijenjeni i da u ovome svijetu postanemo tvoji pravi svjedoci. Blagoslovi nas ti, Gospode, u tome i pomozi nam da svoje misli usmjerimo na tebe i na slavu koju ti nama spremaš. U ime Isusovu te molimo. Amen.
Želim svima dobro veče.
I wish everyone good evening.
I za one koji me ne poznajete.
And for those of you who don't know me.
Moje ime je Branka Slavujević.
Yes, my name is Brankica Slavujević.
Živimo ovdje u Bering Springsu već 16 godina.
We live here in Bering Springs for the last 16 years.
Naše dve devojčice i moj suprug Vladimir.
My two daughters and my husband Vladimir.
Posao koji radim nije prijatan.
The job that I do is not very welcoming or pleasant.
Ali ja mogu da kažem da ja volim moj posao.
But I can say I love my job.
Ja sam medicinska sestra.
I'm a medical assistant, or I'm actually a nurse.
Radim u cancer center.
I work in a cancer center.
U dnevnoj bolnici.
At the main hospital here in the area.
Gde pacijenti dolaze od kuće.
Where patients come from the house,
da dobiju tretman kemoterapiju.
Where they come to get treatments with the chemotherapy.
Zašto sam rekla da volim moj posao?
Why did I say that I love my job?
Učim od njih.
I'm learning from them.
Svaki dan.
Every day.
Me podsjećaju šta je u stvari život.
They teach me and they remind me what life is all about.
Godine od najmlađi pacijent mi je 17 godina.
My youngest patient is 17 years old.
I najstariji je 95 godina.
And the oldest one is 95 years old.
Ove zime sam se upoznala s jednim pacijentom.
This past winter I got acquainted with one patient.
I nekako smo postali bliski. Nekako sam uvijek ja mu davala terapije.
And you know, we developed a close friendship and somehow it ended up that I'm the one that's been giving him treatments.
Posle drugog ili trećeg susreta sa njim,
after second or third acquaintance or visit with him,
on me je upitao vrlo neočekivano.
He asked me a fairly unexpectedly.
Kaže, pitaću te jedno privatno pitanje.
I want to ask you a private question.
Da li si ti kršćanka?
Are you a Christian?
Of course I am. Jesam sigurno.
Of course I am.
Kaže, u koju crkvu ideš?
What church do you go to?
Adventistkinja sam.
I'm an Adventist.
I on se okrene prema svojoj supruzi.
And he turns towards his spouse.
Kaže, jel vidiš, nije ovo slučajnost.
Do you realize this is not a circumstance?
On meni kaže, ti si treća osoba sa kojom dolazim u kontakt u zadnjih mjesec dana.
He tells me, you're the third person that I've come in contact with in the last month.
Iz iste crkve.
From the same church.
I počeo da mi priča prvo iskustvo.
And he started telling me his first story.
Bio na jednom napuštenom putu, vozio se on i njegova žena.
They were driving, he and his wife were driving in a deserted road.
Auto je potpuno stao.
And the automobile stopped completely.
I dok je on pokušavao da zove pomoć,
while he was attempting to call for help,
stao jedan auto iza njih.
One automobile stopped behind us.
Jedna mlada žena izašla.
And one young lady stepped out.
I on je bio malo zbunjen.
And I was, you know, he was a little confused.
I ona mu priđe, kaže, gospodine, vidim da vam treba pomoć.
And she came by, you know, she approached them and asked, mister, I realized you need help.
Kaže, moji četvero dece su u autu, kaže, ali možemo da vas dvoje stavimo, odvešću vas, kaže, do prve automehaničara.
She said to him, you know, my four children are in a car, But you know, we can certainly take the two of you and you know, we can take you to the first mechanic.
On kaže ne, samo ti idi ženo kući, ovdje već se spušta mrak, kaže ovdje nije sigurno.
He says, no, you know, thank you for your offer, but you go, because it's getting dark, you just go and take care of your family.
Ali ona bila uporna.
But she was persistent.
I on je pristao, seli su auto.
And, you know, they accepted her generosity and they sat in a car with them.
I odvezla ih je do automehaničara koji je bio adventista.
And she took them to an auto mechanic who happened to be an Adventist.
I on je brzo pozvao svog čovjeka, dovezli su kola.
You know, and the mechanic, you know, called his worker and they brought the car.
Sljedeći dan auto je bio potpuno u ispravnom stanju.
The next day, you know, they repaired the automobile and the automobile was working fine.
On je htio njoj da plati za uslugu.
He wanted to pay her for her generosity and her help.
Ali ona mu rekla, nemoj da mi uzmeš moje blagoslove.
But she said, do not take my blessings away.
Ovaj automehaničar mu je uzeo jako malu sumu što je njega jako šokiralo.
The auto mechanic also charged him very little, which very, you know, very much surprised him.
I kaže, ja sam postao sa njegov redovni mušterija.
And you know, now I'm his regular customer.
I kaže on, i sad srećem tebe.
And he says, and now I'm meeting you.
Kaže, ali nešto na tvom licu govori da ti imaš Isusa u sebi.
But something on your face is telling me that you have Jesus within you.
Kaže, ali moja žena i ja tražimo crkvu.
And you know, my wife and I were searching for a church.
I ja mislim da smo našli pravu crkvu.
And I think we found the right church.
U ovom tromjesečju imamo pouke iz Biblije koje govore o svedočanstvu za Isusa.
This quarter, you know, we're studying in our Bible lessons about the testimony of Jesus.
Ali vidim da je dovoljno čak i da ne govorimo o Isusu.
But I'm realizing and recognizing that it's we don't even necessarily always have to talk about Jesus.
Mi pokažemo da on živi u nama.
But we live it and we show it that he lives it within us.
Neka svima nama Bog pomogne.
May God bless us all.
Da iako prolazimo i kroz krize,
that even if we're going through a crisis,
i imamo lagodan život.
You know, we have, you know, a fairly good life.
Treba da znamo da Isus živi u nama.
We should know that Jesus lives within us.
Amen.
Amen.
Postoji jedna anegdota da je čovjek došao na vrata raja. I naravno, ko je na vratima raja? Sveti Petar. Čovjek je došao i rekao Svetom Petru, čuo sam da bi ušao u raj, moram da imam određeni broj poena. I evo ovako ću da započnem. Bio sam dobar suprug, bio sam dobar otac i brinuo sam se za moju porodicu. Sveti Petar ga je pogledao i rekao, za to 2 poena. Onda je on rekao, služio sam bližnjima koliko sam god mogao. Davao sam novac, vrijeme, sredstva koja sam mogao. Sveti Petar ga je pogledao i rekao, za to 1 poen. Čovjek je počeo da se zabrinjava. Onda je rekao, znaš, u mojoj crkvi bio sam glavni đakon. Brinuo sam se za sve u crkvi da sve ide glatko organizirano. Sveti Petar ga je pogledao i rekao, za to 0,5 poena. Čovjek se stvarno sad našao u čudu. I onda je rekao, ako ovako nastavim, jedino milost Božja pomoći će mi da uđem u Carstvo nebesko. Sveti Petar je otvorio vrata i rekao, uđi. Iz ove humorističke anegdote možemo da izvučemo vrlo važnu pouku. I možemo da kažemo da smo sretni što naše spasenje i naš ulazak u nebesko carstvo ne zavisi o nama i našim dobrim djelima. Zar niste sretni zbog toga? Ali dok smo na ovoj zemlji, Isus nam je dao različite naloge šta da radimo, kako da živimo, kako da se ponašamo. I ja sam shvatila da u svakom tom nalogu, u svakoj toj zapovesti zapravo se krije blagoslov za nas. I večeras Naš stih za dar čitat ćemo iz Evanđelja po Luci u 6. glavi 38. stih. Dajte i daće vam se mjeru dobru i nabijenu i stresenu i preopunu daće vam se u naruče vaše. Jer kakvom mjerom mjerite i dajete, onakvom će vam se vratiti. Dakle, ima blagoslov i u davanju. Zamolit ću đakona da pokupe dar.
Pozivamo grupu sa Andrewsa dok se skuplja dar da se postavimo tako da bi što kraće trajalo to između znači tačaka čekanje. Znači Andrews grupa odraslih i dece molimo da dođu na binu tako da možemo što pre početi.
Grupa sa Andrewsa će otpevati par pesama zajedno sa našom decom. Naslov prve pesme je To ime divno je. Nakon nje čućemo nekoliko stihova koja će deca kazati na našem i na engleskom jeziku, a zatim sledi pesma pod naslovom Isus je meni sav taj svet. Tu ćemo pesmu isto pevati na oba jezika, a nakon toga deca će otpevati jednu pesmu sama pod naslovom I got peace like a river. Želim da vas Bog blagoslovi dok slušate ove pesme i stihove iz Biblije.
Jer nema drugoga imena pod nebom danoga ljudima kojim bi se mi mogli spasiti. Jer Bogu tako omile sve da je sina svojega i da narodnoga dao da nijedan koji ga veruje ne pogine da ga da ima život večni.
Isusa iz Nazareta kojega pomaza Bog duhom svetim i silom i koji prođe čineći dobro i iseljući one koje je đavo nadvladao, jer Bog beše sa njim.
Zato i Bog njega povisi i dava mu ime koje je veće od svakoga imena.
Please.
znate da se on javi da grehe naše uzme i greha u njemu nema. I znate da se on javi da grehe naše uzme i greha u njemu nema. Ko ima Sina Božega ima života, ako nema Sina Božega nema života.
Evo ide na oblacima i ugledat će ga svako oko i koji ga probodoše. I zaplakat će se za njim sva kolena zemaljska, da zaista.
Evo će doći skoro platama sanu da dam svakome po devima njegovi.
Jesus Christ did the same yesterday and today and forever.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want.
What's with the busted one? There's still the edge and it does not.
Jesus, can be saved, God's man, my Predivan muzički program, zar ne?
Beautiful musical program, isn't it?
Hvala svima koji su se trudili da na ovakav način pripreme naša srca za reč Božju.
Thank you all who were preparing and put effort to prepare our hearts to listen to the word of God.
Prvo dobro veče svima želim.
First of all, good evening to all of you.
Svima vama koji ste ovde u sali.
All of you that are here in the hall.
I svima onima koji nas gledaju možda na internetu.
And all those of you who are watching us on the internet.
Moja duboka želja je da nas Bog dragi blagoslovi danas.
My wish is that God would bless us richly this evening.
Možda razumete moju uzbuđenost što
Perhaps you understand my excitement.
Prvo zbog mesta na kome se nalazimo.
First of all, because of the place where we are.
A drugo, zbog mogućnosti da se susretnem sa mnogima od vas.
And the second, my, you know, chance to meet and get introduced to most of you.
Mnoge od vas poznajem 30 godina ranije.
Many of you I know from 30 years ago.
A neke od vas čak sam doveo i do krštenja.
Some of you I even led to baptism.
Ali za mene je prava radost da upoznam mnoga nova lica, mnoge nove duše.
My real joy is to get to meet some new members, some new souls.
Želim vam od srca Boži blagoslov.
I wish you from my heart or bottom of my heart God's blessings.
I molite se Bogu i za mene da mogu na pravi način da vam iznesem reč Božju.
And pray for me so that I can in a real way present the word of God to you.
Pre nego što počnemo, molim vas, pognimo svoje glave da se pomolimo Bogu.
Before we start, can we pray?
Gospode Isuse, ovde smo pred Tobom došli da se susretnemo na prvom mestu sa Tobom. Gospode, mi te molimo da Duhom Tvojim svetim budeš ovde sa nama, da hodaš među ovim redovima. Molimo te, Gospode Isuse, da ljudi ne vide mene kao govornika, nego tebe. Pomozi da ljudi ne slušaju moje reči, nego tvoje. Gospode, molimo te, neka tvoj dobri sveti duh pokuca na srca svih nas. I pomozi da ovaj sabor bude nešto novo za nas, nešto što će nas dodirnuti, nešto što će nas pokrenuti i nešto što će nas dovesti bliže tebi. Gospode, proslavi se ti, budi sa nama, živi u našem srcu i molimo te dođi što pre. Ovo te molimo kroz Gospoda našega Isusa Hrista. Amen.
Amen.
Jednom je Spurgeon rekao, ja nemam ništa danas drugo da radim, nego da vam propovedam Hrista.
Once the person said, I have nothing to do today, but to preach to you about Jesus.
Je, govoriti o Isusu Hristu je najveća čast za mene.
Talking about Jesus Christ is the largest, the best privilege for me.
S obzirom na to ko je Gospod Isus Hristos,
given that who Jesus is,
s obzirom na to šta je On učinio za mene i vas,
given that what He has done for you and for me,
zaista, za nas je privilegija govoriti o Gospodu Isusu Hristu.
Truly for us, the privilege is to talk about Jesus Christ.
A želeo bih da izrazim jednu svoju želju.
I would like to extend one of my wishes.
A i našu potrebu, u stvari.
And our need.
A to je kakav duh trebamo zauzeti sada ili poziciju.
And that is, what type of spirit or position should we take?
Želeo bih da budemo kao ona žena koja je bolovala 12 godina od strašne bolesti.
I would like for us to take the position of a woman who was afflicted for 12 years from a terrible illness.
Kada je čula da je Gospod Isus u blizini,
when she heard that Jesus was in the neighborhood or close by,
kao što znate, ona je u svom umu imala samo jednu misao.
As you know, in her mind she only had one desire.
Ako se samo dotaknem njegovih haljina,
if I can only touch his robe,
ozdraviću.
I will get well.
Kakva vera.
What kind of faith.
Kakvo poverenje.
What kind of trust.
Ali i isceljenje.
And healing.
Ja vas molim, braćo moji i sestre,
I ask of you,
zauzmimo takav stav.
Let's take that position.
Samo da dodirnem Hristove haljine.
If I can only touch Jesus's robe.
Sila će izaći iz njega.
A power will come from him.
Isceliće će moju dušu.
It will heal my soul.
Molite se, nemojte propustiti ovu priliku.
Pray, don't lose this chance.
Nemojte dozvoliti da Isus prođe i bude ovdje, da se nismo svojom vjerom dodirnuli njegovih haljina.
Don't allow Jesus to be present, but we did not touch his robe.
Ako bi se to dogodilo, to bi bio promašaj.
If that happens, that's a big miss for us.
Molim vas, sebe radi i Hrista radi, dodirnimo Hrista ovih dana.
I ask you, for your sake and Jesus' sake, touch him this weekend.
Radeći sa ljudima već 31 godinu,
working with people for a little bit over 30 years,
ono što sam naučio jeste,
one thing that I've learned,
da je Isus istinska da je Isus istinska i najdublja čežnja ljudskog srca.
That Jesus is truly the biggest desire of man's heart.
Naše srce treba Hrista.
Our heart needs Jesus.
Naša savest treba Hrista.
Our mind needs Jesus.
Naše celo biće treba Hrista.
Our whole being needs Jesus.
Mi čeznemo za Hristom možda čak i ne znajući.
We yearn from him, not even knowing about it.
Ali vi znate da mnogi ne znaju za to.
But you know that many people don't know about that.
I to je tragedija za njih.
And that's a tragedy for them.
Međutim, jedna vatrenost za Hrista je najuzvišenija strast.
In the meantime, one desire for Christ is the biggest desire.
Najveća strast jednog Hristovog sledbenika.
It's the biggest desire of one follower of Jesus.
To je bila preovladavajuća strast apostola Pavla.
And that was the biggest desire of Apostle Paul.
Mi se pitamo zašto je Pavle bio tako revan za Boga.
And we ask ourselves, why was Paul so fervent for God?
Zato što je on imao duboku čežnju za Hristom.
Because he had deep desire for Christ.
On je ljubio Isusa Hrista.
He loved Christ.
I više, on ga je obožavao.
And more, he worshipped him.
I on ga je propovedao.
And he thought he was teaching him.
Pogledajte par stihova koje ovdje nalazimo u Filipljanima.
Let's follow a couple of verses that we found in Philippians.
Kaže Isus Pavle, kaže, jer za mene Isus je život.
And Apostle Paul says, for me to live is Christ.
Na drugom mjestu opet kaže, više ne živim ja.
And someplace else it says, I no longer live.
Nego Hrist živi u meni.
But Christ lives within me.
Pogledajmo Pavlovo svedočanstvo koje je on izgovorio.
Let's try and see Paul's testimony that he said.
To čitamo u Filipljanima 3. glavi.
And we read that in Philippians 3rd verse.
Od recimo 7. stih.
7th verse, 3rd chapter.
Ono što mi je bilo nekada bilo dobitak,
what I had considered a gain once,
radi Hrista to smatram gubitkom.
For Christ I consider that to be a loss.
Ja sve smatram gubitkom, kaže, u poređenju sa onim što sve prevazilazi.
I consider all this to be lost when I compare it to everything that comes by.
Yes. I sve smatram za smeće samo da Hrista dobijem.
And everything else I consider for garbage but to gain Jesus Christ.
I da se nađem u njemu.
And to be found in him.
Još više, kaže, želim da upoznam Hrista.
And even more, he says, I want to get to know Christ.
I silu njegovog vaskrsenja.
And the power of his resurrection.
I čak i više od toga.
And even more so.
I zajedništvo u njegovim stradanjima.
And togetherness with his suffering.
Postajući kao on.
Being like him.
U njegovoj smrti.
In his death.
Primetite, dakle, kakva snažna ljubav prema Hristu.
Recognize one thing. What kind of powerful love towards Christ.
Sve smatram za smeće, Hrista radi.
Everything I consider to be garbage in order to gain Christ.
Da li je to tvoj stav prema Hristu?
Is that your position towards Christ?
Da li osjećaš nešto u srcu svom prema Hristu kao Pavlo?
Do you feel something like that in your heart? Towards Christ, just like Paul did.
Želim da upoznam Hrista.
I want to know Christ.
Želim da upoznam njegovu silu, kaže Pavle.
I want to learn about his power, says Paul.
Pogledajte koliko se Pavle odrekao sebe.
Recognize how much Paul sacrificed or gave of himself.
Želim da imam zajedništvo sa njim u stradanju.
I want to have a unity with him in his suffering.
Želim da postanem kao on.
I want to be like him.
Ali kaže u njegovoj smrti.
But in his death.
Ovo je nešto neverovatno.
This is something unbelievable.
Vi znate koliko je Satana šibao apostola Pavla.
You know how the Satan was punishing apostle Paul.
Ali vi znate da mu ništa nije mogao.
But you know he couldn't do anything to him.
A Satan je računao da će se on uplašiti stradanja i da će prestati da propovjeda Hrista.
Satan was counting that Paul would be afraid of suffering and then he would stop preaching about Christ.
Ali Pavlova odbrana je bila.
But Paul's defense was,
a to je on želi da imitira Isusa Hrista.
But he wanted to emulate Jesus Christ.
On želi da trpi sa Hristom.
He wanted to suffer with Christ.
To može samo čovjek koji je doživio Hrista.
The only person can do, that can go through that is the one who truly lived him.
To može samo neko ko, za koga je Hristos živa osoba.
That can only be for somebody for whom Christ is a live person.
Ja bih želio da svi mi budemo takvi.
I want for all of us to be like that.
To je moja najdublja težnja.
My deepest desire is that.
Ja želim da bar malo imitiram Hrista.
My desire is to, if at least a little, imitate Christ.
Znate li nekoga ko je ljubio Isusa Hrista možda više od Pavla?
Do you know anybody who was loving Christ perhaps even a little bit more than Paul?
Da li znate kako je Ellen White ljubila Hrista?
Do you know how Ellen White loved Christ?
Kad čitate to vidite dubinu njenog predanja Hristu.
When you read about her, you recognize the depth of her commitment to Christ.
Kao ljudi koji su pozvani od Hrista,
as people who are called from Christ or by Christ.
Ovo treba da bude vladajuće načelo našeg života.
This needs to be a guiding principle of our life.
Takva strast za Hristom čini vas različitim od drugih hrišćana i ljudi.
That kind of desire for Christ makes you different than the different Christians.
Po tome se poznaju Božja deca.
Makes you different than other Christians. By that are they recognized who are God's children.
Ali vi znate da, nažalost, mnogi hrišćani veruju u Hrista, ali ga ne poznaju.
But you know, the unfortunate part is, a lot of people believe in Christ, but they don't recognize him.
Nažalost, samo neki mogu iskreno da kažu.
But, you know, unfortunately, only few can say with a deep conviction,
moja strast je Isus.
My desire is Christ.
Samo on je prvi u mom životu.
He is the first one in my life.
On je vrhovni i najviši u mom životu.
He's the pinnacle of my life.
Da li želite da to bude vaše iskustvo?
Do you want this to be your testimony?
Da li ste spremni da danas i ovih dana donesete takvu odluku?
Are you ready to today or this weekend make that kind of a decision?
Jer od ove odluke zavisi naš život, braćo moji i sestre.
But from this decision, our life depends on it.
To nije prazna priča.
This is just not an empty story.
Mi trebamo Isusa Hrista.
We need Jesus Christ.
Živog.
Alive.
Silnog.
Strong.
Isusa koga obožavamo.
Christ whom we worship.
Nažalost, vi znate koji ste stari adventizam u našoj zemlji.
Unfortunately, those of you who are older, you know the Adventism in our land.
To je bio adventizam vrlo strog.
That Adventism was very strict.
To su bila pravila i pravila.
That consisted of rules and more rules.
I prvo pitanje je bilo, šta ne smem da radim?
And the first question was, what am I forbidden to do?
I mi smo imali tih pravila jako mnogo.
And we had many of those rules.
Ali smo zaboravili Hrista.
But we forgot Christ.
Mi smo propovedali 10 zapovesti.
We were teaching 10 commandments.
Hristov dolazak.
Christ coming.
4 zveri.
4 beasts.
I rogove, znate one 10 rogova.
And horns and 10 horns and all that stuff.
Ali smo potpuno zaboravili Hrista.
But we forgot about Christ.
Naše crkve su postale hladne.
Our church became cold.
Kritizerski nastrojene.
Critically positioned.
Pronalazili smo mane jedan u drugome.
We found faults in one another.
Samo zato što nismo bili slični Hristu.
Just because we were not similar to Christ.
Braćo moje sestre, moramo se okrenuti Hristu.
Brothers and sisters, my brothers and sisters, we need to turn toward Christ.
On je naš spasitelj.
He is our salvation.
On nam je sve.
He is everything.
Sva naša doktrina bez njega ne vredi ništa.
All of our doctrine without him doesn't mean anything.
Ali sa Hristom onda je to sila.
But with Christ that is power.
Jeste li spremni da donesemo neke odluke u našem životu?
Are you ready to make some decisions in our life?
Neki od vas ste putovali 1000 km da biste došli ovde.
Some of you have traveled 1000 kilometers to come here.
Nije valjda da smo došli onako samo.
Isn't it, you know, we didn't just come here just for willy-nilly?
Ja bih bio strašno žalostan.
I would be very sad.
Ja bih smatrao da je promašaj i moj dolazak vama ako se tako nešto ne dogodi u našem srcu.
I would consider it my misstep towards you if we go through this experience and nothing happens in your life.
Naše najdublje predanje nečemu ili nekome,
our deepest commitment to something or somebody,
mora biti predanje Isusu Hristu.
Must be a commitment to Jesus Christ.
Mi mora da budemo odani Isusu Hristu.
We need to be committed to Jesus Christ.
Najuzvišenija ljubav na nebu i na zemlji pripada Hristu. Amen.
The highest love on in heaven and on earth belongs to Christ. Amen.
Amen. Thanks. Celo naše biće treba da upija našeg Gospoda.
Our whole being needs to absorb our Savior.
Poznavati Hrista sve više i više je naše najpotrebnije znanje.
Knowing Christ more and more is our deepest need.
Zadovoljiti njega sve više i više, to mora biti naša najveća glad i žeđ duše.
Satisfying him more and more, that must be the biggest thirst of our being.
Proslavljati Hrista u našem životu sve više i više mora da bude naša najveća ambicija.
Our largest and biggest ambition should be in our whole being is to worship Christ.
Vi znate apostola Pavla.
You know Apostle Paul.
Bio je neprijatelj Isusa Hrista.
He was not a friend of Jesus Christ.
Ništa nije znao o Hristu.
He didn't know anything about him.
Bio je slep za Hrista.
He was blind towards Christ.
Proganjao je Boži narod.
He was torturing God's people.
Terao je ljude da kunu, da psuju Isusa Hrista.
He was forcing people to curse Christ.
Ali kad mu se Hristos otkrio,
but when Jesus revealed himself to him,
kada je video njegovu slavu,
when he saw his glory,
taj čovjek se promenio.
He changed.
I on je bio šampion, dakle, propovedanje Isusa Hrista, njegove slave i onoga što je učinio.
And he became a champion of preaching his glory and what he did for him.
Najdublje misli koje nalazimo o Hristu nalazimo u Pavlovim poslanicama.
The deepest thoughts that we find about Christ we find in Paul's epistles.
Zato što je taj čovjek susreo Hrista.
Because that man met Christ.
Zato što je tom čovjeku Isus Hrist bio živa osoba.
Because for that man, Jesus Christ was a live person.
To je naša opasnost, braćo moji i sestre, da gledamo Hrista samo u Bibliji, ali ne i u našem životu.
That is our dangers, brothers and sisters, that we can only see Christ in the Bible, but not in our life.
Isus je više od jedne istorijske ličnosti.
Jesus is more than just one historical person.
Vi znate, Isus je rekao, ja ću biti s vama.
You know Jesus said, I will be with you.
I mi to trebamo. Isus je obećao.
And we need that, and Jesus promised that.
I zato mi nismo siročad.
And that's why we're not orphans.
Zašto da živimo kao siročad kad Isus kaže, ja ću biti s vama?
Why should we live like orphans when Jesus said, I will be with you?
Svojim svetim duhom Hrist želi da živi u nama.
With his Holy Spirit, Jesus wants to live within us.
I to je naša najveća potreba.
And that is our biggest need.
Za njega kaže, kao što kaže Pavle, mi živimo ili umiremo.
As the Apostle Paul says, for him we either live or we die.
Njemu se mi okrećemo za mudrost.
Towards him we turn to for wisdom.
Od Isusa tražimo vodstvo i silu.
From him we're looking for leadership and power.
U njemu je naša slava.
In him is our salvation.
U njemu mi stojimo.
In him we stand.
U njemu smo mi savršeni.
In him we are perfect.
U njemu smo mi opravdani.
In him we are justified.
U njemu smo mi posvećeni.
In him we are sanctified.
U njemu smo mi bezgrešni.
In him we are without sin.
Isus je sve za nas.
Jesus is everything for us.
Samo u njemu mi možemo stajati pred Bogom.
Only in him we can stand in front of God.
I to je razlog zašto naša srca treba da se okrenu njemu.
And that's the reason that our hearts need to turn towards him.
Dakle, to mora da bude naša najveća strast.
That has to be our biggest desire.
Strast koja treba da nadvlada sve druge hrišćanske ili nehrišćanske strasti.
Desire that would overwhelm all the other Christian and non-Christian desires.
I to je ono što je najvažnije za naš život.
And that is the most important thing for our life.
Je samo jedna strast može biti u našem karakteru.
Only one desire can be in our character.
A to je strast za našeg Gospoda
Isusa Hrista. And that is our desire for Jesus Christ.
Isus je naš cilj.
Jesus is our goal.
Isus je naš primer.
He is our example.
On je naša čežnja.
He is our desire.
Isus je naša besmrtna nagrada.
He is our great award.
On je naša alfa i omega.
He is our alpha and omega.
I zato što je sve ovo on,
and yet because he is all of this,
on treba postati naš ljubljeni.
And he needs to become our loved one.
On je ljubljen, očev ljubljeni.
He is loved by the Father.
Ali mora biti naš.
But he needs to be loved by us.
To je jedina nada za naše spasenje.
That's the only hope for our salvation.
Ako Hristova osoba i njegovo delo ne privuče nas Bogu,
if Christ's persona and his deeds don't bring us closer towards God,
ako Hristova osoba ne dovede nas do pokornosti Bogu, mi smo izgubljeni.
If Christ's persona doesn't bring us closer to be humbled towards God, we are lost.
Jer Bog nema drugog sredstva kako da dodirne tvoju dušu i moju.
God doesn't have any other means by which he can touch your soul and mine.
Zato ne igrajmo se sa ljubavlju Božjom.
So let's not play around with God's love.
Ne igrajmo se sa Božjom milošću.
Let's not play with God's mercy.
Jednostavno dozvolimo da nas magnetna sila Hristove ljubavi privuče Bogu.
Let allow ourselves that the magnet of God's love brings us closer to God.
Nemojmo da se bojimo toga.
Do not be afraid of it.
Zato što mislimo da ćemo nešto izgubiti.
Because we think we're going to lose something.
No, mi ćemo time dobiti sve.
No, we're going to gain everything by that.
Isus nije kradljivac neke naše sreće ili zadovoljstva.
Jesus is not making a decision about our happiness or our All right, go ahead.
Baš naprotiv, on je darodavac svakog istinskog, zdravog, blagoslovenog zadovoljstva.
On the contrary, he is the giver of every true happiness.
I vi znate da je Gospod Isus Hrist rekao za nas.
And you know what Jesus said Christ said about us.
Ljubi Gospoda Boga svim svojim srcem i svom dušom i svom misli.
Love thy God with all your might, with your heart and your mind, and your soul, and with all your mind.
Dakle, primetite, Gospod Isus traži celo naše biće.
And recognize, Jesus is looking for a whole being.
Da li se ustručavamo da damo Hristu naše srce i dušu?
Are we hesitant to give Christ our soul?
Pa zar je moguće da tako nešto postoji?
Is it possible that something like that exists?
Ako stvarno poznajemo Hrista.
If we truly know Christ,
naša najdublja težnja za Hristo mora poticati da potiče na osnovima ljubavi prema njemu.
Our deepest desire for Christ needs to be based on our love towards him.
Naš odnos sa Hristom treba počivati na našem najdubljem ličnom predanju njemu.
Our relationship needs to be based on our deepest commitment to him.
Mi trebamo biti oduševljeni njegovom ličnosti i njegovim delom.
We need to be delighted with his persona and his deeds.
I mi trebamo jedan mir i jedan živi odnos sa njim.
And we need one peaceful but live relationship with him.
Vi znate ovaj tekst. Znači, ko ljubi više oca i mater nego mene, nije mene dostojan.
You know this text says, he who loves father or mother more than me is not worthy of me.
Isus traži sve.
Jesus is looking for everything.
Otkud mu pravo da traži sve?
Where did he get that power to ask for everything?
Zato što je prvo on dao sve.
Because he first gave everything.
On je Bog.
He is God.
On je stvoritelj.
He is the creator.
On je spasitelj.
He is the salvation.
I on je dostojan našeg predanja njemu.
And he is deserving our commitment to him.
Braćo moji i sestre, mi zaista trebamo da volimo Isusa Hrista.
My brothers and sisters, we truly need to love Christ.
Svrha Biblije je da nas upozna sa Hristom.
The purpose of the Bible is for us to form a relationship or to recognize Christ.
A onda da nas dovede do dubokog odnosa sa njim.
Actually, to introduce us to him and then to form a deep and relationship with him.
Cilj spasenja nije ništa drugo.
The salvation plan is nothing else.
Nego da uspostavimo jedan duboki odnos ljubavi sa Hristom.
But to form a deep relationship with Christ.
Hrišćanski život nije ništa drugo nego u stvari jedan pravi odnos ljubavi sa Hristom.
Christian life is nothing more but one true relationship with Christ.
Pogledajte ovaj citat.
Let's look at this verse.
Naš otkupitelj žeđa za tim da ga upoznamo.
Our Redeemer thirsts for recognition.
On je gladan saosećanja i ljubavi od onih koje je otkupio svojom krvlju.
He hungers for the sympathy and love of those whom he had purchased with his own blood.
Isus je žedan tvoje i moje ljubavi.
He's thirst for yours and my love.
On je gladan saosećanja i ljubavi od onih koje je on otkupio.
He hungers for our love, for those whom he redeemed.
Dokle će Isus biti žedan?
How long will Christ be thirsty?
Dokle će Isus, kao što vidite ovdje, biti gladovati?
For how long will he be hungry?
Vi znate, mi smo bića koja trebaju ljubav i koja vole.
You know, we are beings who need love and who do love.
A Isus je također biće koje voli, ali koje čezne i da bude voljeno.
And Jesus is also a being who loves but also needs to have that love in return.
Tako nas je Bog stvorio.
That's how God created us.
Zašto?
Why?
Zato što želi da uspostavi odnos ljubavi, poverenja, zajedništva sa svojim stvorenjem.
Because he wants to form that tight relationship based on life, on love, togetherness.
Bog je mogao čovjeka da stvori u obliku neke životinje.
God could have created man in form of some kind of an animal.
Možda nekog mikroba.
Maybe some kind of a microbe.
Ali on ne može onda da ima jedan duboki odnos ljubavi i poštovanja sa takvim bićima.
But then he couldn't have really one deep relationship based on love and respect with those kinds of beings.
Zato Biblija kaže da nas je stvorio po svom obličju.
And that's why the Bible says he created us in his likeness.
Bog želi da ima jedan inteligentan odnos sa nama.
God wants to have one intelligent relationship with us.
I Bog želi da ima jedan duboki odnos ljubavi sa nama.
And he wants to have one deep love relationship with us.
Braćo moji i sestre, najveća opasnost za nas,
brothers and sisters, the biggest challenge for us,
može se dogoditi ako smo toliko zaposleni da nemamo vremena za razvijanje takvog bliskog odnosa sa Hristom.
And our biggest danger could be that we don't have time to develop that kind of relationship, the deep relationship with Christ.
To nije, ja ne govorim o nekom osjećajnom, previše osjećajnom odnosu.
I'm not talking about some kind of a feely relationship.
Ja govorim o tome da moramo imati jednu svijest o veličini Hristovoj.
I'm talking about that we need to recognize God's greatness.
I da imamo odnos ljubavi prema njemu.
And that we have the relationship of love with him.
I najveći problem za nas ako tu ljubav izgubimo.
And the biggest challenge and the problem for us if we lose that love.
Ako možda čak se i okrenemo od Hrista.
And even if we turn away from Christ.
Onda je to propast.
And that's a big tragedy.
A vi znate, Biblija kaže da je Isus sav ljubak.
And you know, the Bible says Jesus is whole love.
Isus je zastavnik između tisuća, kaže naš prevod.
And you know, Jesus is representative of thousands.
Sve oči su uprte na njega.
All the eyes are pierced towards him.
Sva čežnja celoga svemira sada su uprte Hristu.
All the desires of the whole world is focused towards Christ.
Celi svemir voli i obožava Hrista.
The whole world is focusing in worshiping Christ.
Uskoro će naša zemlja, buntovnička zemlja, da dođe u okrilje Božeg naroda, naroda u svemiru i da se priključimo njihovom obožavanju Hrista.
And soon our rebellious planet that we live on is going to join that whole cosmos that is focused on worshiping God.
Odanost prema Hristu i izražavanje ljubavi prema njemu je jedan voljni čin.
A commitment to Christ and expression of our love to him is one voluntary thing.
To je više od emocija.
It's more than emotions.
Ti moraš odlučiti da pripadaš njemu.
You have to make a decision that you belong to him.
Mi moramo odlučiti da odvojimo vreme za Hrista.
We have to make a decision that we're going to allocate time towards Christ.
Mi moramo odlučiti da mu se predamo.
We have to make a decision to commit ourselves to him.
A iza toga dolaze emocije.
After that the emotions come into.
Ljubav prema Isusu Hristu,
love towards Christ.
Nije religijski osjećaj,
it's not a religious feeling,
nego duboka ljubav prema njemu.
It's a deep love towards him.
Zato što je to jedan stvaran odnos sa njim.
Because that's one true relationship with him.
Vidite, mi se radujemo u njemu.
Recognize we are happy within him.
Mi nalazimo odmor u njemu.
We rejoice in him. We find peace in him.
Mi se družimo sa Hristom tokom dana.
We rest in him. We fellowship with him throughout the day.
Mi podižemo svoje lice k njemu.
We focused our face towards him.
Vi vidimo njegov osmeh koji je upućen nama lično.
We see his smile that was directed towards us.
I mi smo tada pokrenuti do suza.
And we were touched towards tears.
Videći njegov mili pogled upućen nama.
Looking at him with his, you know, smile looking towards us.
Kad pogledamo Hrista u oči.
When we look Christ in his eyes.
Mi vidimo njegovo oku Otca i Krsta.
In his eye we see the reflection of the cross.
Mi vidimo njegovu veliku ljubav koja je večna.
We see his great love that is forever.
Mi znamo da nas on ljubi.
We know that he loves us.
Ne samo da ljubi ovaj svet.
Not that he only loves this world.
Tebe ljubi.
But he loves you.
Sa svim tvojim slabostima.
With all your weakness.
On te ljubi onakav kakav jesi.
He loves you the way you are.
I on je spreman da te još više ljubi i da te promeni.
And he is ready to love you even more and to help you change.
I Isus je spreman da posveti vreme svoje da bude sa nama.
And Jesus is ready to commit his time to be with us.
Šta je subota?
What is Sabbath?
Pa to nije ništa drugo nego jedan sastanak.
That's nothing more than one gathering.
Sećate se kad ste se zaljubili u svoju dragu ili ona u vas.
You're remembering now when you first fell in love.
I vi ste uvek zakazivali sastanak. Naći ćemo se u to vreme.
And you were always focusing, you know, and making arrangements to meet and this and this time.
Da bi bili zajedno.
That you would be together.
Da bismo se više upoznali.
So that we could get to know one another.
Da bismo izgrađivali dublje naš odnos ljubavi.
So that we can form our deeper love relationship.
Pa to je subota.
But that is Sabbath.
To je subota, dan kada se susrećemo sa našim voljenim Gospodom Isusom Hristom.
That is Sabbath. That's a day when we get together with our Christ.
To je dan kada imamo dublji odnos sa njim.
That's the day when we have a deeper relationship with him.
To je dan koji će stvoriti takav odnos da mi zaželimo da budemo večno, večno married, kako se kaže?
Venčani.
Venčani sa njim.
That's the day that's going to form a big desire for us to be married to him.
Imate li tu duboku želju da budete zaista venčani sa Hristom za svu večnost?
Do you have that deep desire within you to be married to Christ for the eternity?
Po koga Isus dolazi?
For whom is Christ coming?
Po koga?
For whom?
Jeste. Ali kaže po svoju nevestu.
But he's coming for his bride.
Da, po svoju nevestu.
Yes, for his bride.
Da li si ti Hristova nevesta?
Are you his bride?
Da li želiš da budeš sa njim za svu večnost?
Do you want to be with him forever?
Da li to poznavanje koje imaš sada sa Hristom želiš da se ozakoni brakom?
That relationship that you have formed with him today, do you want that relationship to end in marriage?
Vi znate da Biblija kaže da Isus ženik.
You know that the Bible talks about Christ as being the groom.
Isus kao ženik prilazi svakom od nas i kaže: "Hoćeš li da budeš sa mnom za svu večnost?"
Jesus as the groom is reaching out to all of us and asking, "Do you want to be with me for eternity?"
Isus kaže: "Ljubim te."
Jesus says, "I love you."
Isus kaže, spreman sam da ti oprostim tvoje grehe.
I am ready, Jesus says, to forgive you all your sins.
Isus kaže, spreman sam da ti dam silu da pobediš neke slabosti.
Jesus says, you know, I'm prepared to give you the power to overcome some of your weaknesses.
Isus kaže, ljubim te uprkos tvojih slabosti.
Jesus says, I love you despite all of your weaknesses.
Isus kaže, ma ne mogu ni te slabosti tvoje da nas odvoje jer te volim.
Jesus says, even your weaknesses cannot separate us because I love you.
Kada to shvatimo,
when we recognize that,
kad prepoznamo taj glas Hristov našoj duši,
when we recognize the voice of Christ in our soul,
onda kažemo, evo Isuse, potpuno sam tvoj.
And then we can say, here Christ, I'm wholly yours.
I onda istinska promjena u našoj duši dolazi.
And that's when the real change happens within our soul.
Isus nas je ljubavlju zadobio.
Jesus Christ got us with his love.
On će nas i ljubavlju posvetiti.
And he will sanctify us with his life.
On će nas i ljubavlju spasiti kada dođe.
And he will save us with his life, love when he comes.
Ne budite hladni prema Hristu.
Don't be cold towards Christ.
Nemojte čitati Božju reč tu, a razmišljati da Isus 12.000 ili 12 milijardi svetlosnih godina daleko od nas.
Don't read the Bible and God's word, you know, thinking that, well, I'm reading this, you know, but Christ is, you know, 12 million years, light years away.
Isus je taj koji nas ljubi, kaže Božja reč, večnom ljubavlju.
Jesus is the one, as the Bible tells us, that loves us with eternal love.
Šta znači to večnom ljubavlju?
What does that mean, that eternal love?
Vi znate, večnost se prostire u daleku prošlost.
You know that eternity goes back, way back.
Pre nego što nas je stvorio, on nas je voleo.
Before he even created us, he loved us.
On je bio jagnje Božje zaklano od pre postanka sveta.
He was the lamb that was sacrificed before the beginning of the world.
Nemojmo slušati Satanina došaptavanja.
Don't listen to Satan's little chirping.
Kad nam govori da nas Isus ostavlja čim učinimo jedan greh.
When he tells us that Jesus is ready to leave us,
to nije istina.
That's not truth.
Zato što je Isus baš tada uz nas.
Because Jesus is at that moment with us.
Jer on ne diže svoje ruke od nas.
Because he doesn't lift his hands away from us.
On nas još više ljubi kada mi više trebamo njega.
He loves us even more when we need him more.
Jednu misao sam shvatio pre izvesnog vremena.
One thought I finally rationalized, you know, not too long ago.
Kaže ovako, Isus je više spreman da nam oprosti greh.
It says this way, Jesus is more apt to forgive our sin,
nego što smo mi spremni da grešimo,
then we are ready to sin.
Amen. Je.
That's
naša
true.
Sklonost jeste ka grehu, ali je Isusova ljubav veća od te naše sklonosti ka grehu.
Our natural tendency is towards sin, but Jesus' love is bigger than that.
Isus je spreman da nam oprosti.
Jesus is ready to forgive us.
Isus je spreman da nam da silu.
He's ready to give us the power.
Ali te sile nema nezavisno od njega.
But that power does not exist absent of him.
Mi kažemo Isuse daj mi silu da pobedim greh.
We say Jesus give us power to overcome sin.
No, pogrešno je to.
Well, that's wrong.
Idi Hristu.
Go towards Christ.
Proučavaj o njemu.
Learn about him.
Uspostavi zajednicu s njim.
Establish a relationship with him.
Neka se ljubav i odanost u tvom srcu rodi prema njemu.
Let the love and the commitment towards him be born within you.
Onda ćeš mrzeti greh.
Then you would hate sin.
Onda ćeš ga odbaciti.
Then you can toss it away.
Onda će Hrist u tebi pobediti greh.
Then Christ will within you win over sin.
Jer ta sila koja pobeđuje, to je samo Hrist u nama.
Because that power that wins, it's Christ within us.
I zato vidite koliko nam je Isus potreban.
And that's why you can see how much we need Jesus.
Da li prihvatamo Hrista za cara našeg života?
Are we accepting Christ as the king of our life?
Da li smo spremni da uspostavimo jedan lični, duboki odnos sa njim?
Are we ready to develop a personal...
Ja verujem da Isus govori našoj savesti.
But I believe Jesus is talking to us.
Ja verujem da Isus vas poziva kroz ovo.
I believe that Jesus is calling you towards this.
I molim se Bogu da odgovorimo na Hristov poziv svi mi.
And I pray to God that we would answer Jesus' call, all
ja,
of us.
Ja trebam Hrista svaki dan.
I need Jesus every day.
Ja trebam njegovu krv.
I need his blood.
Ja trebam njegov svetog duha.
I need his Holy Spirit.
I ja trebam ličnu zajednicu sa Hristom.
And I need that personal relationship or togetherness with him.
Ono što meni treba, treba i tebi.
And the things that I need, you need as well.
Hajde da odlučimo večeras.
Let's decide this evening.
Gospode, želim više vremena da provodim sa tebe, sa tobom.
Christ, I want to spend more time with you.
Gospode, želim da mi bude živa stvarnost.
Jesus, I want you to be live for me.
Otkri mi se, Gospode, više i više.
Reveal yourself more and more.
Jer hoću da upoznam tvoju ličnost.
Because I want to learn about you more.
Ako je to molitva tvog srca.
If that is your prayer, if that is the prayer of your heart.
Ako je to duboka čežnja tvog srca.
If that is a deep desire of your heart.
Slava Bogu.
Glory to God.
Tu čežnju, tu molitvu je Sveti Duh stavio u tvoje srce.
That desire, that prayer, the Holy Spirit is implanting in your heart.
Neka je slava našem Gospodu Isusu Hristu.
May the glory be to God and our Jesus Christ.
I neka Bog učini da zaista svi mi donesemo takvu odluku.
And may God help us to all make that kind of a decision.
Nemojte reći sutra ću doneti odluku.
Don't say tomorrow I will make a decision.
Vi znate Dwight Moody tu u Chicagu.
You know that Dwight Moody here in Chicago.
Propovedao je silno Božju reč.
He was a strong preacher of God's word.
Pozvao ljude na odluku.
He asked people to commit.
A onda im je rekao, sad idite kući, pa razmišljajte, pa donesite sutra odluku.
And then he told them, you know, go home, think about it and make a decision tomorrow.
I onda je došao onaj tajanstveni požar u Chicagu te noći.
And then the big Chicago fire came that night.
Mnogi njegovi vernici su bili, izgubili su život.
Many of his worshippers lost their lives.
Crkva u kojoj on propovedao izgorala je do dna.
The church that he was preaching in was burned down to the bottom.
I onda je on rekao sebi,
And then he said to himself,
kakav promašaj?
What kind of a mistake?
Kaže, rekao sam ljudima da idu i da razmišljaju, pa da sutra donesu odluku.
I told people to go home and think about it and make a decision tomorrow.
Umjesto da sam ih pozvao da donesu odluku danas.
Instead of asking them to make that decision today.
Bio sam mlad propovjednik u Nišu.
I was a young pastor in Niš.
I proučavao sam s jednim prijateljem koji se zvao, mislim, Slaviša.
I was studying with one friend whose name is Slaviša, I think.
I tokom dana sreo sam ga u gradu, on je na motoru bio.
And throughout, you know, one day I met him in a city, you know, he was on his motorcycle.
On kaže meni, zdravo Dušane.
Hey, he said, hello Dušane.
Ja njemu kažem, zdravo, zdravo.
Hey, zdravo, zdravo, how are you?
Kažem, vidimo se sutra na biblijskom proučavanju.
Okay, I'll see you tomorrow in our Bible study.
Dolazim, čekaj me.
I will be there, wait for me.
Te noći.
That night.
Išao je da dočeka svoju devojku.
That night he went to wait for his girlfriend.
Koja je radila u drugoj smeni.
She worked second shift.
I tamo negdje oko pola 11.
And about 11:30, about 10:30.
Na večer, dakle.
In the evening.
Išao je da je pokupi.
He went to pick her up.
Međutim, on je bio kratkovid.
But in the meantime, he was nearsighted.
Nije vidio parkirani jedan traktor sa ugašenim svjetlima.
He did not see one tractor that was parked with no lights on.
I direktno je svojim motorom naletao na taj traktor.
And he ran into that tractor direct head on.
I poginuo je na mjestu.
And he died in the spot.
Taj sutrašnji naš biblijsko proučavanje nikad nije došlo.
That tomorrow's Bible study never happened.
I imao je dobru želju.
He had good desire.
I ja sam imao dobru želju.
And I had a good desire.
Ali smrt ga je razdvojila.
But the death separated us.
Braćo moji i sestre, nemojmo odugovlačiti.
My brothers and sisters, don't delay.
Ako ti danas govori Sveti Duh,
if the Holy Spirit is speaking to you today,
recite Isusu, želim svim srcem da ti služim.
Tell Christ, I want to worship you with my whole heart.
Želim da ti budeš živ u mom srcu.
I want you to be alive in my heart.
Isus čeka za takvu molitvu.
Jesus is waiting for that kind of a prayer.
On je žedan da čuje takvu molitvu.
He thirsts to hear that kind of a prayer.
On, kao što smo vidjeli ovdje, čak i gladuje za takvom ljubavlju.
And he is hungry, as we recognize this evening, for that kind of love.
Ako vam je Isus simpatičan,
if the Jesus is appealing to you,
ako ga volite,
if you love him,
onda donesimo odluku da imamo jednu dublju zajednicu s njim.
Let's make that decision to have a deeper relationship with him.
Bog neka vas blagoslovi u toj odluci.
May the God bless you in that decision.
Amen.
Amen.
Drago mi je što vas mogu pozdraviti večeras i drago mi je što su večeras zastupljene ovdje različite generacije, od beba koje su stare nekoliko mjeseci pa do onih koji su već sa sedom kosom. I sada bih željela da postavim pitanje onima koji su možda stariji i koji imaju više iskustva. Da li je neko od vas ikada u životu doživio buru na moru? Ima nekoliko ruku. Možda bi savremenije pitanje bilo da li je neko doživio turbulenciju kada je letio avionom. Najverovatnije, tu ima malo više ruku. Ne znam šta ste razmišljali u tim trenucima. Ne znam kakve ste odluke donosili. Međutim, jedan stih koji nam govori o tome kakve misli treba da nas vode u takvim trenucima zapisan je u knjizi proroka Isaije koji kaže: kada pođeš preko vode, ja ću biti s tobom. Ili preko reka, neće te potopiti, kada pođeš kroz oganj, nećeš izgoreti i neće te plamen opaliti. To je upravo pesma o kojoj će izvesti Trio Slavujević i vi dotle razmišljajte o tome kakve su odluke koje donosite kada se nađete u burama svog života.
Thank you. Jesus,
Sklonit ćemo svoje glave da se molimo Bogu. Gospode Isuse, tebi smo zahvalni što si govorio srcima svih nas. Gospode, ti znaš naša srca, našu potrebu za tobom, ti znaš našu ljubav, a znaš također i strepnje našeg života i našeg srca. Gospode, pomozi nam da te više poznajemo. Pomozi nam da te više volimo. Pomozi nam da imamo više vremena za tebe. Pomozi nam da te obožavamo u našem srcu i našoj duši. Pomozi nam da ti zahvaljujemo svaki dan. Pomozi nam, Gospode Isuse Hriste, da uspostavimo takav odnos sa tobom koji će nas dovesti do večnosti. Gospode, blagoslovi svako gladno i žedno srce večeras. Blagoslovi svaku dušu koja čezne za ovakvim odnosom sa tobom. Blagoslovi, Gospode, i one koji su možda daleko od tebe. Blagoslovi mlade i našu decu. Utisni tvojim svetim duhom u njihova srca ljubav prema tebi. Gospode, pomozi da ovaj sabor bude sabor gde ćemo sresti tebe, gde ćemo doživjeti tvoj blagoslov, gde ćemo doneti nove odluke i gde ćemo sa novom silom voditi naš hrišćanski život. Blagoslovi nas sve, dodirni nas svojim svetim duhom, svojim prstom. Gospode, ovo te molimo i zahvaljujemo i obožavamo i Oca i Sina i Svetoga Duha. Amen.
Dobroveče i Boži blagoslov svima.
Good evening and God's blessings to all.
Želim da vas pozdravim u ime organizatora Sabora ove godine.
I'd like to welcome you in the name of the organization of Sabor this year.
I zaista nam je prednost da budemo svi ovde zajedno sa vama.
Actually, I'd like to welcome you as the director of Sabor for this year, and it's my privilege to be with you.
Thank you, Milan.
All right.
Da. Verujem da smo svi bili ohrabreni večeras.
I believe we were all uplifted this evening.
Kada smo moja supruga i ja tek pristupili crkvi, sećamo se propovedi pastora Dušana Milosavljevića.
When my wife and I, we just joined the church, I still remember the sermon of Mr. Milosavljević.
I bilo je slično ovako.
It was similar to this.
On je uvek pun ohrabrenja i pun poziva, direktnih poziva da ljudi zaista slede Boga.
And he was always full of asking and people to make a commitment towards glorifying God.
I to je ono što je nama tada zaista trebalo.
And that's one thing that we really needed that time.
I to nam je pomoglo da donesemo tu odluku da zaista prihvatimo Hrista kao svog spasitelja.
And that's one thing that helped us to make that commitment and the decision to follow Christ.
I verujem da će za neke od nas zapravo ovo biti posebno iskustvo.
And I believe that for many of us, if not for all of us, this is going to be a special occasion.
I siguran sam da će neki od nas doneti tu odluku da ponovo učine taj poseban zavet sa Gospodom, da mu se zaista istinski približe.
And I believe that many of us are going to be touched to make that recommitment to be close to him.
Zato vas pozivam da se molite u tom smeru i da kada dolazimo ovde, da dolazimo u tom duhu traženja Gospoda.
And that's why I ask you that you pray towards us, and as we come back and refocus ourselves, you know, as part of this gathering, to pray towards that goal.
Par važnih obaveštenja.
Couple of very important announcements.
Prvo, sutra ujutru u 7:30 imamo jutrenje u Limeson Hallu.
First, you know, as our usual, we're going to have our morning worship service at 7:30 in Limeson Hall.
I pastor Goran Živković iz Toronta će imati sa nama jutrenje.
And pastor Goran Živković from the Toronto Church will have the morning worship.
I ja vas ohrabrujem da dođete i da se nahranite i da njega podržite također.
And I encourage you to come and be fed and to welcome him.
Pošto primite duhovnu hranu,
after you receive spiritual food,
onda vas pozivam da dođete na doručak.
Then I encourage you to come for breakfast.
I Mila, gde će tačno biti breakfast?
The breakfast is going to be in the cafeteria. Doručak će biti u kafeteriji.
Ono što je jako važno jeste da dođe što veći broj nas.
One thing that's very important is that as many people as possible come because we have to make a commitment to a number of people for breakfast.
Dakle, postoji nova organizacija u kafeteriji i oni žele da postoji zaista dobar broj ljudi koji će dolaziti da bi oni u budućnosti nastavili da obezbeđuju doručak za nas.
There's a new organization that's running the cafeteria. It's been outsourced and you know, they're asking for our commitment to have a number of people present during breakfast.
Ako pogledate raspored, dakle u 8:45 počinje subotna škola.
If you look at the back of your bulletin, 8:45 is Sabbath school starting.
Mi smo pokušali da napravimo raspored na zadnjoj strani da koji će dati generalnu ideju kada se šta dešava.
We tried to make the bulletin so that one page summarizes what's happening and when.
U svakom slučaju, ako otvorite buletin u samoj sredini,
In any case, if you open the bulletin right in the middle,
tu ćete videti detalje vezane za bogosluženje.
You will see the details associated with each one of the worship services.
Kao i sa svakim bulletinom, tako i ovde uvek ima nekih malih ispravki.
As with any bulletin that gets put together, there are some minor corrections that need to be put here.
Uvek postoji potreba da se nešto promeni iz jednog ili drugog razloga.
And there's always a need to make some changes.
Tako budite milostivi ako vidite da je nešto malo drugačije.
And please be forgiven if something, you know, doesn't work and line up exactly as stated. You know, we need to maintain flexibility.
Želeo bih isto da vas zamolim da dolazimo malo ranije ovde da bismo mogli da počinjemo bogosluženja na vreme.
And I would ask you if at all possible to come on time or perhaps a little bit earlier so that we can start, you know, on time because it's very important.
Ako pogledate raspored, sve vrlo onako tesno poslagano.
If you look at the schedule, you know, everything is compacted, you know.
Mi moramo završiti bogosluženje na vreme da bismo stigli na ručak na vreme.
We need to finish our worship service on time so that we can make it for lunch on time.
A moramo završiti ručak na vreme da bismo došli na vreme na workshops.
And we have to finish lunch on time in order so that we can attend the seminars.
Da, u svakom slučaju ne želim više da trošim vaše vreme za ovo. Biće više informacija sutra, ali probajte da dolazite na vreme i da se držimo rasporeda jer će to sve učiniti lakšim i lepšim.
I don't want to prolong this announcement, but you know, the critical piece here for us is to be on time so that, you know, we can adhere to the schedule that's been pre-programmed.
Za večeras je važno da oni koji učestvuju u horovima odmah posle bogosluženja dođu napred kako bi otpočeli sa probom.
The thing that's important this evening is for those of you who are practicing in the mass choirs to stay in here, move up to the front pretty quickly so that we don't have to prolong this evening forever.
Da, znam da bismo svi želeli da pričamo, ali što pre počnemo sa vežbom, pre ćemo završiti.
I know that we all like to visit and talk to each other, but you know, the sooner we get the practice over with, the sooner we can, you know, fellowship.
Što se tiče sutrašnjih proba,
as it pertains to tomorrow's practices,
dakle, od 4 do 6 popodne sutra ćemo ovde imati muzičke probe.
From 4 o'clock to 6 o'clock tomorrow afternoon we will have practice sessions.
Ja ću ovo ponoviti još jednom, ali generalni raspored je sledeći.
I will go through this schedule, but in general it is such.
Chicago u 4 sata.
Chicago is allocated a 4 o'clock time slot.
Elk Grove 4:25.
Elk Grove Church is 4:25.
Toronto 4:45.
Toronto 4:45.
Andrews 5:30.
Andrews 5:30.
Dakle, ja ću dati papiriće vođama muzičkih sastava tako
Andrews da needs, you know, 3 hours, you know.
3 hours. Okay. Da. Mislim, ovo su otprilike, znači, vreme, to je neka moja slobodna procena koliko vam treba u odnosu na tačke koje ste prijavili.
This is based on the subjects or the
estimation.
My estimate as to how much time you're going to need based on what's recorded here as to the subjects you're going to have.
Da, možda neće biti tačno u minutu, zavisi od vas.
You know, we need to maintain a little bit of flexibility.
ali generalno, znači, Chicago 4 sata, Elk Grove 4.25, Toronto 4.45, Andrews 5.30.
So in general, you know, you have 25-minute increments between churches, right? Chicago, Elk Grove, Toronto, and then Andrews.
Da, malo više za Toronto i Andrews.
Well, you know, Toronto needs a little bit more time because they have more topics, but that's okay. We'll work through it.
Dobro, u svakom slučaju, na kraju želim da vam se zahvalim da ste došli u petak.
You know, towards the end, I'd like to thank you for coming on Friday evening.
Pokušajmo da održamo zaista dobar duh na ovom saboru.
Let's keep the spirits in a positive way.
Ako vidite da je neku potrebi, pomolite se sa njim.
If you see that somebody has a need, pray with him.
Nemojte samo da se pozdravljamo.
Don't just shake somebody's hand.
Ako vidite da je neku potrebi, zašto ne kažemo jednom drugom, brate, da li mogu da se pomolim za tebe?
If we see that somebody is in need, why don't we just say, brother, can I pray with you?
Iskoristimo ovu priliku da se duhovno nahranimo i da duhovno nahranimo druge.
Let's use this chance to be fed spiritually and to be of spiritual food to somebody else.
Neka vas Bog sve blagoslovi.
May God bless you all.
Amen.
Amen.